Hello everybody and welcome to my week 6 match. This week we are facing Tokuvar, and Tokuvar is our lord. I am don't for sure know his win-loss ratio as of right now, but he is a really good player and he has a really scary team because he has the likes of Mega Blastoise, which my only switch into is an Assault Vest regular Blastoise, which can't do much back. He also has a Uxie, which is a decent switch into Terrakion, but it's whittled quite easily. He also has a Lucario, which can be quite a threat. A Scolipede and Baton Pass class is not a thing in this league, so he can run SD, Speed Boost and Baton Pass it to whatever. That's really scary. He also bought Zapdos, which is just a Zapdos, it doesn't do much special, Hidden Power Ice and Thunder Bolt and stuff like that. He also has a Victini, which can be quite a threat, but I do have a Mega Altaria, which is quite nice for the Victini. Anyway, as I said, I do have Mega Altaria for the Victini, so that's really nice. I also have a Zap Blade Jolteon. He had a Crocodile, so I wanted to be able to switch your moves, because I have Protect for the to see if Crocodile will lock himself in like Pursuit, if he's Scarfed or Earthquake or Knockoff, so I can see like if he goes for Pursuit I can stay in a Signal Beam, if he goes for Earthquake I can switch into my Yamega possibly. I also have some kind of standard Yamega obviously, Speed Boost Shenanigans. I also have a Nidoqueen which is Scarfed because I needed to revenge some shit like Lucario, and Nidoqueen is the only mod on my team that can take a plus 2 Bullet Punch and a plus 2 Extreme Speed after Stealth Rocks. And he well, if he's E-Speed, he can touch Terrakion. So I'm not sure whether he brings Bullet Punch or E-Speed. But with Bullet Punch, he can't really touch Jolteon very hard. But I think touching Terrakion is more important. Anyway, Assault Vest Blastoise, as I said, and a Terrakion with a Sugar Berry, because I overprepared for the Crocodile, which he obviously did not bring. Anyway, without further ado, let's just get on with this match. I lead off with my Jolteon because he has absolutely nothing for it, as he leads to this Uxie. I just get off damage on this Uxie because I wanted it whittled for Nidoqueen and Terrakion. I go for a Thunderbolt and then a Volt Switch and go into my Blastoise, hoping he would stay in so I can get a nice and what's the move? The mom move with the, so that I could get a Rapid Spin off. Then he goes into his Zapdos and the Hidden Power Ice is predicting my switch, which is quite a good move in it, but I just gathered my rocks because I want my Stealth Rocks up. Anyway. Okay. He goes for 2 Hidden Power Ice, which is the obvious Hidden Power Ice. But I helped a friend of mine with a mock battle and he had an electric type. Oh, I mean I had an electric type because I used the opponent's team and that had a fast electric type. And Hidden Power Water made sense on that team because the opponent had a, I believe, yeah, he had an Excadrill and a Hippowdon. So HP Water was better coverage than Hidden Power Ice. So I was in my head, I was thinking he had Hidden Power Water, even though I know Hidden Power Ice makes way more sense against my team. Even though Hidden Power Ice does jack shit to Mega Altaria, it still makes way more sense. But I just had Hidden Power Water in my head, so I thought he was Hidden Power Water. Also, he could have possibly predicted my switch and went for Thunderbolt, but he didn't. And sometimes you just gotta laugh it off. It was a honest mistake, it can happen, it was a brain fart, but I can still possibly roost up on the, because I have on like a Victini possibly, I guess, if he gets like weak hit drops. I'm not sure if I outspeed, but that's my only hope pretty much, because Uxie has a really high base speed, so that's not nice. So I just go into my Jolteon hoping to do something as he goes for another Hidden Power. I just go for a Thunderbolt as he goes for the Defog actually, getting rid of my rocks, which is nice for Yamega. Now I do go for my own Volt Switch as I switch it to my Terrakion because he's probably not going to go for a Electric move, or so I thought. He went for the voltage. Now he goes into his blasters as I go into my blasters, and he goes for the Scald. And he gets a first turn, Scald burn, which is really unfortunate. He now goes for our spear as I do in fact go for my own Scald. And that does 19%, which is nice because I was in torrent range. As he now reveals the water spout, which is a really cool move to have on the Mega Blastoise. Anyway, I know I can definitely one-shot him with a Thunderbolt right now, but he might have thought he could survive a Thunderbolt because he didn't know I was. He may not have known I was Zap Blade. He thought I was like some kind of non-boosting item, like I don't know, a berry or something. Anyway, he now goes to Victini as I protect to see what kind of move this Victini wants to go for. And I calc and I know I can live a Church Guard Psychic. So I go for the Vultures and I see that he is actually Assault Vest Victini. And he now goes to the VK. So if I sacked something else, I could have possibly went to the Mega Altaria and hoosted up again. Anyway, that's how the cookie crumbles. Mega Altaria is dead and now my Terrakion just comes in and gets a kill because he doesn't have a switch in for Terrakion. At all. So he now goes to Lucario. I'm afraid of a Focus Sash or a Choice Scarf variant as he actually doubles into his Zapdos, which is a good play on this part, but now he can get his Zapdos back up. I now go into my Jolteon, wanting a definite safe switch into my Terrakion. I go for a Thunderbolt and here I'm considering switching into Terrakion because I know he has to roost if he wants to 1v1 my Jolteon. But I also know that he is a smart player, so he probably will predict my very obvious switch into Terrakion right now. So I go for another Thunderbolt, thinking he had about Ice? No, huh? I mean, thinking he might go for Thunderbolt or something, but or Volt Switch. Oh wait, did he even have Thunderbolt? No, he didn't have Thunderbolt. Oh wait, I never meant to switch into Terrakion. I think I meant Nidoqueen to say Nidoqueen, but I thought the Nidoqueen was too obvious, so that he would predict my Nidoqueen switching. Anyway, he did not, and now I just want him to get in definite range of having to roost again, because I think every turn I'm too scared to switch out. Anyway, I do get a crit, which is 6.5% chance, as I learned today, and 6.5% times like times 5 is like higher than 30%. So, I mean, it's still unfortunate for him, and crits do suck still, but I mean, at this rate, I guess, yeah, I'm still, it's not as if, I mean, I didn't go for the crit, and I'm trying to justify it, but, I mean, I'm still sorry for that, Tokuwar. Anyway, I now do go for a Thunderbolt just to finish this off. As he now switches into his Victini, which is his, which can take a Thunderbolt. But I'm just sacking my Jolteon at this point, because those two things can easily pick off Jolteon at the point it's at. I now do just go into my Terrakion, getting another kill, as he now goes into his Colibri. And I was thinking, so I just thought about clicking Stone Edge, not wanting him to set up, but Nidoqueen was way less important, so I could just sack Nidoqueen, then go into my Young Mega and win. But I could also sack Terrakion, go into Young Mega and win. But Terrakion could still take a bullet punch from the Lucario, and Nidoqueen couldn't not. So that's why Terrakion was more important in my eyes. Anyway, I just sacked the Nidoqueen as he goes for the Sword Dance, which is quite unfortunate. He goes for Poison Jab, actually, revealing that he doesn't have Mega Horn or Aqua Tail. So that's really nice for me. He goes for another Poison Jab, as I now am able to go into my Young Mega. And now. I go for an Air Slash, and I miss. And that's quite unfortunate, because Mega Air Slash would have two-shotted, and I could have gone for double protect and outspeed the Lucario. So basically, all this came down to was a 50-50, literally. In no one's control, it came down to a double protect. But thanks to this Air Slash miss, it now comes down to a flinch, because I have a 30% chance to flinch with Air Slash after the double protect, so I have to win the double protect and flinching. So that's obviously what I'm going to do. Oh, wait, he outspeed, I didn't go for protect, defense of your mega. Max defense your mega, oh my lord. And it takes Whirlwind your mega. The Whirlwind. What the fuck is the. Huh? I didn't even know Yamega got Whirlwind. Boost Yamega. Max defense. 68 defense. Base defense. 68 base HP. Which is a really random number. But it's still 68. So 68 Yamega pulling through. 68. Base defense. It can take on. It was the only thing on my team that could take on. That could switch into an offensive Scolipede and a baton passing Scolipede, because Gligar can't handle a baton pass Scolipede because it's Cerebonner. Blastoise can't handle an offensive Scolipede. And what else did I have? Probably something else, I don't know. Yamega was the only thing that could take hits and learn a phasing move, which was definitely key. And on top of that, it could take hits from Lucario too, which was very nice. And people often think about Yamega and think late game cleaner, choice packs, bullshit. It has 68 base defense and 68 base HP. Its special defense is absolute crap, but don't take this thing for granted. It can live hits if you invest enough. It can be. Speed boost is also nice for defense, because outspeeding the opponent's offensive Pokemon with your wall is really nice if you want to roost on it and stuff like that. So obviously I did win. I'm very happy with this win. Yamega pulled through. I'm really, really proud of Yamega. And I love the reactions of everybody, like, oh my lord. Everybody was going wild when they saw Yamega living a plus 2 Ice Punch. Defensive Yamega, never thought I'd see the day. That's what someone say, I don't know who that is. People saying LMAO, that was cool. Lelbut is also, I think, something said. And someone typed in caps lock, wait, and what the fuck, and I love reactions, and I love creativity, so Yamega, yay, Yamega, yay. Also, he was Charty Berry on his thing, on his Scolipede. Also, you might think, Yamega doesn't handle offensive Scolipede because Rock Slide is a move. Well, there was absolutely zero reason for him to run Rock Slide. Because the perfect coverage for him was Aqua Tail, Mega Horn, Poison Jab, Protect. There was absolutely no reason for him to run Rock Slide. My only Rock weakness on this team is Yamega. Which is really nice, because people don't have to run rock coverage. Because my other flying type is Gligar, and that's not weak to rocks, obviously. So, without further ado, I'm going to end this video right now. I've been rambling for long enough. Defensive Omega, yay, bye. Oh, by the way, GG Tokvar.